How to Make a Book, Part 2. This is going to begin with making the end papers and move on to stitching, saddle stitching the pamphlets into the binding. So first I rip two end papers that fit about an eighth of an inch from the outside corners of the book. Then I spread glue evenly across the two end papers and apply the end papers and really work them down so that they are well adhered to the fabric and cover right up to the edges as evenly as I can. Now I'm going to want to press it under some heavy books and we'll set that aside and come back to it. So the next step is to use the template for the the leaflets to rip as many other leaflets as I need to fill the book. You may have begun with all of your leaflets already ripped, but if not, this is when you fill the book with the leaflets necessary to make it even. So here they are. I'm going to stack them together, page through them, try to really press down on the fold side so that I can get them tight to the spine of the book. Thread my needle, mark the back of the spine, and now I'm going to use the awl to drill little holes. I want to use a rotational motion to sort of ease it through. Do this on top of a piece of card so that the needle has somewhere to go without scarring up your work surface. And then flip the hardback over and you can emphasize those holes or find them on the inside. They're not always very visible depending on the fabric you used for your hinge. So I line up the first leaflet and now I can use my awl or a needle to poke a hole in line with the hole in the spine. Do that on each side. I look and sort of eyeball the location, and then I feed the thread out through the leaflet and then through the spine, back through the spine, and into the other end of the leaflet. You may have to wiggle it around a little bit to try to find the hole that you pre-punched in the leaflet. So now you've gone in one full loop. You're going to tie a knot right to the corner. Nice double knot that won't untie itself, or surgeon's knot, if you know how to do that. And then you're going to send the needle back out through the same hole that you started with in the top of the leaflet. And it should pop out. I'm hunting here for it. It's not always right where the hole in the leaflet is. You have to sort of look behind the leaflet and make sure that you're going out the same hole that you went out the first time. So I come out the hole, and now I'm going to go across the spine and into the next hole. So I'm going to go out the first hole and into the second hole in my row. Now I'm going to do the same thing again with all the other leaflets, going around in a loop, out the second hole and in the third hole, through the leaflet, out the third hole and in the fourth hole, through the next leaflet, out the fourth hole and in the fifth hole. So you can see I'm spiraling around the spine to lock all of these leaflets against the spine. Now I've got my last leaflet, and I'm going to go through that one. And this time I make sure it all fits and I really tap it down to get it to sit tight. Now I'm going to take up the slack in the thread along the spine. So I really want to take the slack up so that the leaflets fit really tight against the spine. You may have to cinch down the stitching two or three times to really get it tight. It's worth doing this because it'll give you a nice firm binding. Then you can send the needle back through the last hole and come out, slide the needle under that last saddle stitch and around into a surgeon's knot. That's two passes through the loop and a pull it tight. And that's your stitch. Now, making sure that that knot goes down tight against the hole. And now I'm going to cut off my excess thread, check my stitching, and then I like to tie an hourglass shape in some of the books. This not only is a nice decorative effect, it also makes the leaflets sit just that much tighter against the spine. And we're done.